Yeah, but guys, the hypotheticals in this case are terrifying. What if that bomb didn't explode at 9:30 at night when no one was around? What if a mail carrier trying to deliver letters tripped off the powerful explosive? Or if the selectman's 7-year-old daughter tried to get the mail the next day? Thankfully, no one got hurt here, but the so-called pranksters, if caught, are facing steep charges.
This is the crime scene. Brick rubble, twisted metal, a newspaper box askew. Around 9:30 Sunday night, a pipe bomb shattered the peace and quiet on Horn Road.
It was an ungodly explosion.
Yeah, it wasn't smoking, but you could certainly smell, I guess, what was probably a black powder or a sulfur type smell.
This is clearly the mailbox where the pipe bomb was placed, but this belongs to the house across the street. All told, 3 mailboxes reside here on Selectman Cormier's property.
Selectman Ron Cormier lives here at 22 Horn Road and has been a selectman for 6 years. He's now the chairman of the board.
And you are an elected official in your town. Do you feel targeted here?
I don't. I don't believe that it had anything to do with the local politics. At least I hope it didn't.
When Belmont police arrived Sunday night, Cormier says they recovered a piece of twisted, mangled metal.
It looked like a pipe maybe 6 or 8 inches long, inch and a half in diameter.
Neighbors here agree that Horn Road is a hot spot for mailbox baseball. And the consensus is that the vandals simply upped the ante with an explosive.
I think it's one of those things where They were a little upset that they could never get at those mailboxes because they were encased in concrete, and somebody finally found a way to do it.
Ron Cormier has replaced his mailbox in time for Wednesday's delivery. But Alice Brown and her neighbor are having to drive to the post office to collect their mail.
Are you angry?
A little bit. Yeah, a little bit, because that's quite a destruction.
Selectman Cormier is so convinced this is not about his position, he joked with us that he ran for county commissioner last month and lost by 17 votes. He says maybe if he won, he might consider this prank deliberate, but he's confident this is just a random, dangerous act of vandalism. And police say it could lead to felony charges if they catch whoever's responsible. Live in the studio, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.